So this next information may or may not be true. That's what I'm gonna like. Very, very true. All right, so our headliner for the night is from Jamaica. He has been doing his So our next headliner comes to the stage is from Jamaica, and he is an internationally known comedian that has appeared on HBO, Comedy Central, and he's also produced two of his own comedy specials. And you can also catch him with his doing his acting thing on True TV's You Can Do Better. Give it up for our headliner, Ian Sal.
Thank you. DJ, keep that playing, please. Keep it playing. You know, yard man from the stage. You know, so you want to feel. You know, if you cut when we say cut, right? Play the bomb. Play the flows and skirt music. Because you're going to be an intricate part of the show. Don't go to sleep. You're going to work for your money now. How you doing, ladies and gentlemen? You'll be hearing me slip in and out of Jamaican periodically through this show. That's just how it goes. I'll give it up for your host, though. She did a great job. That may be true or it may not be true. Nobody, did you not fact find the information? Like, said that several times. Like, this may be true, or it may not be true. 25 years, yeah, I think it's true. I've been around. I'm loving the stage, man. Give it up for this. Give it up for the stage hand that put this together right here. I mean, Jesus Christ. The hours they put into this.
You stupid guy. Yeah, that's
kind of... Look at this. This is beautiful, man. Lord have mercy. I don't deserve this. It's actually bringing back memories of a birthday party I had when I was a kid. No, seriously. You ever had things that trigger stuff in your past? This stage is triggering stuff in my past. I had a birthday, and it was a surprise birthday party. My mom put it together. They spent hours on it. They had balloons like this all over the house. All over the house. And apparently they spent every dollar they had on the balloons, because I didn't get but one present.
That is out of line, yeah.
And that was a coupon for a Big Mac at McDonald's.
Now that's fun.
But those are fond memories. Fond memories. Don't let my anger lead you away from the fact that I'm reminiscing.
That's right, that's right.
I don't get to perform on theater stages that often. I'm usually in comedy club. So whenever I get on a theater stage, I feel like I need to be theatrical.
Right, right.
It's gonna be some theatrics going on. You know. So I get a little loose, a little animated. I did Shakespeare. I actually did Shakespeare at one time, man. I formal trained at Willie Mammoth Theater Company in Washington, D.C. I got an award for playing Othello.
All right, all right.
Yes. Guess who I was? That's right. Othello. But it wasn't an Othello, the Shakespeare version of Othello that you might think it was. This is what we call the ghetto version of Othello. See, the Shakespeare version of Othello was like, this is her, my drink is the white woman sitting on the edge of her bed. And I'm Othello circling around her. This is the Shakespeare version of what we did. By heaven, I saw the handkerchief in his hand. O perjured woman, thou thus stone my heart, which makes me call what I'm about to do, murder. See, that's the Shakespeare version. But we did the ghetto version. Wasn't quite like that. That's the white woman sitting on the edge of the bed. And this is me. Oh no! Oh, you old cheat! Oh my God! I saw his little handband in your pocket. That's why what I'm about to do is call a OJ.
That's out of line. End scene.
It was a ghetto award. Did I mention it was a little ghetto award? Oh man, I'm having fun up here, man. This is feeling so animated. It's so magical up here. Goddamn. Where else can you do a comedy show where you can just kick it? White Hollywood is falling apart. Ain't
falling apart, God.
Oh,
yes, sir.
Gosh.
Yes, sir.
Man, more white actors are being accused of touching people. Wow. I've actually seen more white people get in trouble on the news than black people this month.
That's right.
You feel me? One white person. Oh, that's two. Oh, that's three! Can we get four? Can we get five? Man, they coming out the woodwork, man. Ladies, give yourself a round of applause. Give yourself a round of applause by saying, you can't touch me like that no more.
That's right.
You can't touch me like that no more. That, fellas, this is a great time to get in a long, loving relationship. Trust me. If you are in a long, loving, healthy relationship, clap right now. If you're not, tell his name or her name. Snitch on him.
You're stupid.
I'm happy I'm in a relationship right now because I would not want to be in this dating culture. I wouldn't even know how to go on a date and be, like we say in Jamaica, koof. You know what I'm saying? Koof. Koof mean like cool. Like you know, not a, you know, like I'm not that weird dude. Like I wouldn't know how to do it right now. It's weird, you don't know what to say. You don't know how, like you might be going through a door, I put my hand on your back, you be like. It's weird, you know? It's weird. These guys are out here doing some weird stuff, man. Harvey Weinstein took the cake. Now here's the thing. He been molesting, abusing, assaulting women for over 40 years.
Right.
40 years.
40 years, anybody say that?
And it took him assaulting a ficus plant for this to come to head.
Wow.
Yes, the tree people were not going to stand for it. God damn it, every woman raised up. He assaulted a ficus plant. If you don't know what the ficus plant and why Harvey Weinstein got to do with each other, Google it, because it's a clean show. I noticed something because I used to work for law firms and I was a legal researcher, so I see little things and I pick up on details. Yes, you know what I'm saying? I don't smoke weed like the other lady. I see details.
You're stupid.
Not weed in hands. It's just part of my nature. What I noticed is that these serial sexual offenders have a similar trait, and that's that lazy eye. Both of their eyes are just lazy. Harvey Weinstein got it. Look, when you go home, you might not laugh at this joke, but when you go home and Google these photos, you're gonna be dying at your computer desk. Harvey Weinstein got the little lazy eye. Bill Cosby got the little lazy eye.
Wow.
Now you know what that's. You know what causes that, right? Constant winking at women. Eventually that eye get tired. I'm just gonna stay like this.
That's stupid.
If that's what you like to do, I'm just gonna stay like this.
That's cold. That is cold right there, man.
It's crazy. That's why I'm glad I'm in a loving relationship.
That's stupid, Doc.
Did I mention that comedians lie sometimes?
Sometimes.
Okay. But if you didn't know, my bishop was upstairs. He would, you know, like we in church, like I tell a joke, that's right! Like he my hype man, he upstairs.
That's right.
Yes, that's right. Thank you, sir. Thank you. I'm in a loving relationship, but I'm also in a relationship that I can't leave. Anybody ever been in a relationship that they can't leave? Come on now, this is the time.
Tell the truth, tell the truth.
This is the time, this is the time. He will not slap you in here with all these people, trust me. Get your hand out your pocket, sir. We're not gonna let you harm her. I'm in a relationship, I can't leave. I'm afraid to leave. I have been with a ride or die woman for the last 11 years. When I say ride or die, it is ride or die. Feel me? It's like, you're gonna ride, or you're gonna die. Scared, man. Scared to leave her, man. Believe in a relationship that you should have a decent amount of comfortability with each other that and not be insecure with each other. That if you, ma'am, or you, sir, saw another woman out there or another man that was very attractive, you could actually acknowledge that.
Right.
Without the other person feeling guilty about it. Mm-hmm. Yes, that's how I roll. That's how I roll. That's how I feel. But I'm in a relationship that could be detrimental to my health. So I don't play around. I was actually at a bar. I was at a bar 2 days ago. I was on one end of the bar having my drink, because that's my therapy. I get out of the house and I go to a bar where I'm around people that I don't know. People don't know me. I don't know them. And I sit down and I have my drink and I talk to myself. That's my therapy. They don't care because I'm in Hollywood. They think I'm reading a script. I'm memorizing a script or some shit. But I'm basically just saying over and over and again, I'm in a really bad relationship. I don't know how to get out of it. That's all I'm saying to myself. But I was at the end of the bar. And there's a beautiful woman about 3 stools away. Now, I can see her out my peripheral vision because the cataracts ain't got that bad yet. They say when you got glaucoma, that's the first thing to go. You can't see shit. Like, see, I know that wall's black. I'm good. So I see her out the corner of my eye. Beautiful. And she's staring at me. Fellas, you know this. Fellas, only we know this. Women, you think we don't know this, but fellas, we know this. You can always tell when a woman is ready to give you the world. Because she look at you like this.
Yeah. stupid dog.
She was doing that to me, and then I messed around, and we made eye contact, and we were staring at each other. And I looked away quickly, and I told the bartender, I said, "Listen, man, I'm feeling a little uncomfortable. Could you tell that lady stop staring at me?" Because I knew if I had succumbed to that, I know what I would face later. A little whoopee and a good time could lead to homicide. That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying, bro. I ain't trying to be no victim, you know what I'm saying? I'm satisfied with the sex every Tuesday and Sunday, you know what I'm saying? And the drama in between. I'm fine with that. I got a son in college. I'm trying to live to see him graduate. I ain't saying, look, we good. We good. You need to stop looking at me, lady. I'm serious, man. I can't even drive down the street. You put up to a stoplight. A woman pull up next to you. You both sitting there. Violins are playing in the background ever so softly. You look at her, she look at you. You look away and speed off, run the red light. Because I would rather get hit by oncoming traffic than be stabbed multiple times.
You stupid.
At some point, your choice of death is important. Because some deaths are more horrible than the other. That's all I'm saying. Nobody wants to be stabbed multiple times. Right.
Yes, sir.
Somebody said, yes, sir. Oh, my goodness. Have y'all noticed that me and the dude from the Virgin Islands are dressed just alike?
That's coming.
Jeff Hawes, ladies. Get up with Jeff Hawes, ladies and gentlemen. That's a perfect example of how the Virgin Islands always won't be like Jamaica. I came to this country when I was 3 years old. God bless my peoples. My mama, who's passed away, God bless her.
Bless
my daddy,
who's
remarried and got the house and got all the money and got everything and gave his kids nothing. God bless him.
God bless you.
Bastard. They took care of me though, man. I'm glad that my mama had the foresight to come to this country so that I can be in front of you doing this right now. Yeah. Right. My God. I am 52 years old, and who would have thought that this would have been my future? My mama came over here, she worked as a maid and stuff, and she brought her entire family over here.
Wow.
So I am very blessed to have a mother that I have, and my mom wanted her children to know their heritage and stuff, where they come from and stuff. So I always had my Jamaican culture. I always ate my Jamaican food. It never lost me, as you could probably tell. And she always made sure we went back to Jamaica and went back to where we were from. And I remember the first time after coming here when I was 3 years old, I went back when I was 17 years old, because I had no interest in going back to Jamaica. I was fully Americanized. I was like, oh, I'm good. They had to force me. They actually had to force me to go. And I went back, and that's when I realized that my family wasn't that well off in Jamaica. No, we were from the country part, way up in the country, where apparently they had no needs for electricity and water. You know what I'm saying? Like that was for fancy folks. We don't need that stuff. You know?
That's cold, man.
It was shocking. It was shocking. Ladies and gentlemen, when I tell you it was shocking for a 17-year-old man to be taking a bath outside in the backyard in a basin, to black water when they wash their cars now. A basin. I remember asking my auntie, I'm like, auntie, where, I'm gonna take a shower. I've been here 3 days and I haven't seen you. I know y'all think I'm nasty, but you know, at some point, even nasty people need to take a bath. I don't see the bathroom. Where's the shower, auntie? Shower? No, baby, we're not having no shower. Well, I said, what? He said, no, baby, we're not having no show. Are we, you ready for your bath? I said, yeah, I'm ready for a bath. Okay. Junior, go get the piece and I'll fill it up with some water. So I said, yeah, I'm here. I said, what'd you say? Hey, Junior, go and get you the piercing so you can be it. You need soap?
You need some.
Is that a question? Well, through the water here had just natural cleansing chemicals in it. I don't need soap in here. We don't need soap, okay.
Yeah, that's funny.
So Junior come out with the basin and he filled it up with rainwater, which I kind of thought rainwater was not pretty cold. Shit, rainwater? Ah, National Geographic, ah! But then the reality of it hit me. I'm butt naked in the backyard. Sitting in a basin of water that come to my ankle. And I'm, this is what I'm doing here. Automatically, you think somebody watching you. All I'm doing is like I'm scanning the hillside. I'm scanning the hillside. I'm scanning the bushes. I know that somebody is watching me take a bath. And apparently, it's such a natural and normal thing that people will just come up and talk to you while you're out there taking a bath, butt naked. I'm back there taking a bath. And this dude come out of nowhere. Hey, this is Junior. This is Junior. Hey, yo, man. I'm taking a bath, dude. Will you get out of my bathroom?
Stupid. That's sick.
But I love my culture, man. I love my heritage, man. I try to instill it in my son, but he's so Americanized, he don't even know where Jamaica is. He's like, Dad, where you from? Jamaica? Where? What?
That's cold, man.
Really? All right, Dad. I got internet in Jamaica, Dad? I'm gonna send him over there so he can take a bath in the basin in the backyard. Just ground his little butt. Just ground him, cause you know when they think they ecstatic electricity, they the hottest thing. Oh, we just whoa! That's when you ground them. Take a bath in the backyard, naked. So the world can see your little teapot. That's what we call it in Jamaica, a teapot.
That's sick.
I don't have my Jamaican accent. I don't have a Jamaican accent, but it's there. Don't let me fool you. I will never lose that. That is a part of me, just as my arm is a part of my shoulder. It will never go nowhere, and it comes back when it needs to come back. Trust me. Because if you ever know a Jamaican, as soon as you get him mad, you would have thought he was from South Texas, and you get him mad, like, what? Let the bill collectors, like bill collectors, they call my house, that's when it comes out. Spring called my house the other day, they was like, Mr. Salmon, when can we get payment on your delinquent Sprint bill? I'm doing people, man. I'm doing people. I tie my horse and it blows on skirt. Why I'm doing them? Hey, hold on. Let me ask you a question. How you get my blows on skirt? Because there's no money anyway. When you ask Sprint, how did they get your telephone number? That's when the phone lines go silent. Beautiful thing, we both hung up at the same time. But Sprint is clever, man. They're clever. They are clever. They know how to handle any situation to get that money. They call back 2 weeks later. They like, Mr. Selman, we still need your cell phone bill. What are you doing? I'm like, hey, yo, why I'm doing the people, man? That's when something weird happened. They said, hold on. Uh-oh. I got a question. You say what? Hold on, sir.
Hold on.
A few minutes later, they put another Jamaican on the phone. He's like, Ian! I said, yeah, Ian! What to you, man? Why you don't pay the people that money? I'm like, who's this? It's your father! It's your father! Apparently, Sprint will go through any measure to get paid. They will enlist your family members to get that money, trust me. I think I got that. Did I get the light? All right, can I finish my last closing bit?
All right, Doc.
All right, so my closing bit, ladies and gentlemen, I had a great time, by the way. Thank you very much. God bless you. Follow me on Instagram. They'll tell you all. Ian Salmon, Google me, whatever. Just I love it. This is a great audience. Very good job, Lady Mac. Very good job. I always take the time to talk about my son when I close because I love my son. I think I did a pretty good job in raising my son. My son, he plays college basketball right now out in West Virginia.
All right.
And he's doing really good. I'm very proud of him.
All right.
I made sure that he got a basketball scholarship because I was not willing to pay college tuition. You just don't understand how deep that would have dug into my pocket and my weekend golf outings. It's just not gone. I have a lifestyle to hold here in LA, and your education was not a part of that. So I made sure that he was an excellent basketball player and he got a 4-year scholarship. I would like to add that he also had letters from Division I schools for lacrosse. If anybody know what lacrosse is. I didn't know what lacrosse was, but apparently he was a lot better in lacrosse than he was in basketball. He could have been at Notre Dame or any other school.
Yes,
but when they sent the letters to the house and all I saw was those two sticks crossed, I just threw those letters right in the trash. I don't need you be getting involved with no cults or no white supremacist groups or nothing. I don't know what no damn lacrosse is. You know what I'm saying? So that's why he ended up at a Division III school and not a Division I school. He's playing basketball, not lacrosse. That's right. You just can't have that conversation in your neighborhood barbershop. Man, hey, what's up, bro? Man, congratulations. I heard your son got a scholarship. What are you playing? Lacrosse. Lacrosse? What's lacrosse? So, that's why he's playing lacrosse. And another reason that I'm happy for him is because, if you got kids, you know how expensive tennis shoes are, right?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. The last pair of tennis shoes I bought my son before he got a scholarship, $350 Jordans. Yes, because I was invested in his future. Yeah. I remember the day vividly. We walked into Foot Locker. He was standing at the register. He told me to wait at the door because he didn't want me to hear the negotiations he was having with the dude. All I saw was them talking at the cash register. He kept looking at me like this. Then he started walking back to me with the shoes. I saw them, the shoes were glistening. It was like they had their own stage lighting. It was just like a little miniature drone was flying around them, flashing lights on them. And he was walking in slow motion like this. Right up to me, he said, "Dad, these are shoes I want." I went, "How much them shoes cost, Dylan?" He's like, "Dad, they cost $350, but they're great for basketball." I'm like, "What? Man, you know I'm not your real father, right?" "No, I'm not your real father, sir. Your mama didn't want me to tell you, but I'm going to tell you now. I'm not your real father. Matter of fact, let's get your real dad on the phone and see if he can go $325 on these shoes." How about that? $325. He's like, "Dad, stop playing." I was so determined that I was not going to pay $350 for these shoes, I started making up stuff. I tried anything to deter him from getting these shoes. I said, "Man, do you know that Michael Jordan cheated on his wife?"
That's cool.
He's like, "Dad, what that got to basketball? What that got to do with basketball?" I'm going to tell you what it got to do with basketball. You buy them shoes for $350 and you go to your locker, they going to be on somebody else's feet cheating on you. Their shoes that are reasonably priced. Great basketball players. You ever heard of a basketball player by the name of Chuck Taylor? He was like, "Chuck who?" I said, "Chuck Taylor. He was a great basketball player." They're right over there.
Still got shoes.
They come in turquoise, green, all kinds of colors.
Yeah, yeah.
About $34, don't get you a pair. Matter of fact, get you two pairs. I don't want them, Dad. Oh, you don't want them? All right, there's some Arthur Ashes right over there.
Arthur Ashes, right?
Like, who the hell is Arthur Ashe? Yeah. I said, Arthur Ashe was a great tennis player.
That's right.
He was like, "Tennis? Dad, that's tennis. I play basketball." I said, "Don't worry about it. Wear four pair of socks and get your ankles taped. You'll be fine." God bless y'all. Thank you.